el mecanismo de la sociedad civil, por favor.
Thank you, Chair, for giving us this opportunity. I speak on behalf of the CSM, and I was a member of the advisory group, which was present in many of the evaluation meetings that happened in the past year. The CSM has engaged with the CFS evaluation process throughout the past 2 years and has provided many and substantial contributions to it, always with the aim to strengthen the CFS in the spirit of its reform and its vision. To strive for a world without hunger, where the right to adequate food is realized by all. We want to express our gratitude to the two co-facilitators of the last year, Jenny Tian from China and Oliver Melanton from Germany, for their efforts and their leadership. We fully understand that it was not an easy process to facilitate in a complex and sometimes controversial context. With today's adoption of the implementation of the response to the CFS evaluation report, the CFS enters into a new period. The intensive and rather inward-looking period of the CFS evaluation process can now be concluded and should be followed by a period in which all members and participants engage with new spirits and high energy. Now is the time to recommit. We all know the world is not on track to reach the zero hunger goal, which is the goal 2 of the Sustainable Development Goals. SOFI figures on hunger and malnutrition show that we are on the wrong track. We believe that the CFS is a central place to hold the urgently needed, in-depth discussions about the causes, obstacles, and drivers that have led to this alarming situation. Now is the time for all of us, especially governments and RBAs, to revive the commitment to the CFS, its vision and roles, by providing renewed political and financial support to the policy processes and effective functioning of the CFS and to the comprehensive dissemination, use, application, and monitoring of its policy outcomes. To achieve SDG 2 and related SDGs linked to achieving food security and nutrition, it is indispensable that governments and the UN express a new and full recommitment to the right to adequate food and meet their obligations to respect, protect, and fulfill all human rights. Governments must not challenge, but defend and support the human rights mandate of the United Nations. We, the people, are the most critical agents for change. In our mechanism, we have more than 330 million food producers, represented through a large diversity of organizations. We represent women and youth, indigenous peoples and landless, small-scale, and family farmers, artisanal fisherfolks and pastoralists, agriculture and food workers, urban food insecure and consumers. All of these must be heard more strongly in the future at the local, national, regional, and global levels. The implementation report of the response to the CFS evaluation provides the basis to strengthen the CFS, its strategic direction to face the enormous challenges of food insecurity and malnutrition today and in the near future. Promoting the dissemination, use, and application of CFS policy outcomes must be a priority of CFS members and participants during the upcoming years. We particularly invite governments and RBAs to discuss the enhanced use and application of CFS policy outcomes with civil society organizations on the national, regional, and global level. Tomorrow's global thematic event to monitor the use and application of the right to food guidelines is an opportunity to bring the right to food and human rights back to the center of the CFS debate. This approach should frame and guide the upcoming policy convergence processes on food systems and nutrition, and on agroecology and other innovative approaches in 2019 and 2020. We start today the consultation process for the MIPO 2020-2023. It is fundamental that this prioritization process be strongly linked to the CFS vision, its overall objectives and strategic objectives, and puts in practice what was agreed during the CFS evaluation process discussions. We want to highlight the agreement that gender equality, women's and girls' rights, and women's empowerment must be mainstreamed in all CFS processes and activities. Let us work together for the fundamental and continued changes that put people first and place their inclusion, participation, voices, and rights at the center of policy convergence, coordination, and coherence, especially when addressing hunger and malnutrition and their causes. It's time to recommit. Thank you, Chair.